Hola bonitas. El hambre es, I am stuck in that chill. Welcome to Stuck and the Chill Reactions. Today's reaction is going to be M No Love. And it's interesting because in the last video, the last reaction that I did, M had spoke on almost doing a song dissing Lil Wayne. And on the same album, Lil Wayne has a track that he recorded with M. So these two collaborated after M had considered dissing Lil Wayne. I mean, now, in all honesty, how big of you would that have to be? In all honesty, how big of M is that? That's big. That's being real. But anyway, with no further ado, let's go ahead, kick back, and relax. Yeah, it's time to react. No Love, M, featuring Weezy, Lil Wayne. Let's get it. Okay, we can see what's going on in the video already. You know, you got the kid there at school, they playing dodgeball, and these three bigger kids, and just they letting him have it. They basically ganged up on him, and they letting him have it. And then, you know, after the game, here we go in the locker room, and they go in there, they picking on him. And not only are these kids bigger than this guy, but there's three of them. You know that ain't fair. You know that ain't fair. They know that ain't fair, but you know, that's what bullying is. You know, just people just, and it's mean and intent, and it's just, yeah, it's not a good thing. You know, and kids are mean. You know, and if you don't understand that, or you don't know that, then I guess you need to live life a little bit. But anyway, let's get back to this bullying that I'm dealing with and Wayne.
Throw dirt on me and grow a wildflower, but it's fuck the world. Get a child louder. Yeah, my life a bitch, but you know nothing about her. Been to hell and back, I can show you vouchers. I'm rolling sweets, I'm smoking sour. Married to the game, but she broke her vows. That's why my bars are full of broken bottles, and my nightstands are full of open Bibles.
Okay, before Wayne go in, M said, throw dirt on me and grow a wildflower. Like, you throwing dirt on my name, and what happens from it? Your mouth tastes sour, and I'm prospering, basically, is what he's saying. You know, and Wayne got bars. Like, Lil Wayne has, you know, always had bars for the most part. You know, in the very beginning, I wasn't the biggest fan, so, you know, I haven't really paid attention to a lot of his earlier stuff. And I'm talking about, like, when he's a straight kid, you know, and getting it. I think I liked Fireman, and you know, and before that, I don't know if there was a lot that I liked. You know, there was a couple verses on a couple features that he did. But anyway, I don't want to get too deep into that because right now we're on that love, that no love for those who show no love. You don't show no love, don't expect no love, like for real. When you need it, respect no love.
I think about more than I forget, but I don't go around fire expecting not to sweat. And these niggas know I lay them down, make your bed. Bitches try to kick me while I'm down, I break your leg. Money outweighing problems on a triple beam. I'm sticking to the script, you niggas skipping scenes. Be good or be good at it. Fucking right, I got my gun, semi-automatic. Yeah.
He got his gun, semi-automatic. His last name is Carter. You know, that semi-automatic, he let you have it with his gun, his mouth, the words, baby, he spit them at you. But you know, he going in and, you know, he basically saying, you know, just, you know, yeah, I know, let's let him tell the story.
Yeah, I
put the dick in their mouth, so I guess it's fuck what they say. I'm high as a bitch, up in the way, man. I'll come down in a couple of days. Okay, you want me up in a cage, then I'll come out in beast mode. I got this world stuck in a safe combination. It's the cheap code. It's Weezy, motherfucker, blood gang, and I'm in bleed mode. All about my dope, but I don't even check the peephole. So you could keep knocking, but won't knock me down. No love lost, no love found.
It's a little too late to say that you're sorry, yeah. Now you kicked me when I was down, but what you say just don't hurt.
That's right,
it don't hurt.
I don't need you
no more.
Don't wanna see you
no more,
huh, bitch, you get no
love. You show me nothing but hate. You ran me into the ground, but what comes around goes, yeah, around.
If you've ever been that kid, you know exactly what he's going through, and I'm sure you can appreciate this song, and you can, you know, you can really take this one in, you know. And if you haven't, you know, been bullied and all that, you know, I'll just tell you this, you know, certain places, you know, like, and particularly where I'm from, I don't even call it bullying. I just kind of, you know, and it is bullying, you know, and, you know, it, that is the title for it. But I've just moved on to just getting in the way of individuals that don't have good intentions. Like, you know, there's just some people, you know, like in with that Batman movie, The Dark Knight, he said, some guys just want to see the world burn. You know what I mean? And there's some people just have evil intent and they're just angry inside and they're looking for war. You know what I mean? And you as an individual, when you around people like that, they're ready for war. They're looking for war, you know, and looking forward to war. You know, when they get disrespectful and all this and that, and you go to stand your ground, yeah, you better be ready for war. Because if you ain't ready for war, it's going to come to you anyway. And you're going to either have to learn, you know, to deal with it or run from it. Or maybe a little bit of both, you know. In my case, I learned a little bit of both because, you know, it just is what it is, you know. And, you know, my mother taught me when I was young, and it makes so much sense, that a good run is better than a bad stand any day. And that simply means if there's 30 guys that's about to whoop on you, it's a bad stand to try to stand your ground on that. You know what I mean? Unless you can handle that, you know, some type of way. But if you ain't ready to take on those 30 guys, it's a bad stand. A good run will do you good. You understand what I'm saying? And that's not you being a punk or whatever, but, you know, just understand a certain situation. You pick your fights. You know what you can win and what you can't win. You know, and where I'm from, you know, bullying was just like that, you know, and you learn to take your scuffles and your bruises and you do your thug business and keep it moving. But let's keep it moving with this video.
Again, more alive than I have been in my whole entire life. I can, yeah, see these people's ears perk up as I begin to spaz with the pen. I'm a little bit sicker than most. Shit's finna get thick again. They say the competition is stiff, but I get a hard dick from the shit. Now stick it in. I ain't never giving in again. Cross into the wind, complete freedom. Look at these rappers, how I treat them. So why the fuck would I join them when I beat them? Yeah. They call me a freak cause I like to spit on these pussies before I eat them. Man, get these whack cocksuckers off stage. Where the fuck is Kanye when you need him? I'ma let you finish in a minute. Yeah, that rapper's tight, but I'm finished, yeah, with the greatest verse of all time. So you might wanna go back to the lab tonight and scribble out them rhymes you were gonna spit and start over from scratch and write new ones. But I'm afraid that it ain't gonna make no difference when I rip the stage and tear it in half tonight. It's an adrenaline rush. You feel the bass dump on the place all the way to the parking lot, fellow. Set fire to the mic and ignite the crowd. Yeah. You can see the sparks from hot metal. Yeah. Cold hearted from the devil. Guarded the game I so started to rock, fellow. But I'm not even in my harshest. You can still get roasted, cause marshes. Now, mellow till I'm top, pulling from the top. I'm not gonna stop, I'm standing on my monopoly board. That means I'm on top of my game and it don't stop till my hip don't hop anymore. Shit. When you're so good that you can't say, cause it ain't even cool for you to sound cocky anymore. Shit. People just get sick cause you spit, these fools can't drool or dribble or drop anymore. And you can never break my stride, you never slow the momentum at any moment I'm about to blow. You never take my pride, I'm killing the flow. Slow venom, any opponent is getting no mercy, more
they still beasting a little guy, man. They beasting them, man, you know. And the thing is, you know, and like in real life, bullies don't stop, man. Like, it's their everyday thing. It's what they do, you know. And, you know, it's like, it's not like when you go to school tomorrow, it's going to be better. Don't kid yourself. Don't even kid yourself. And as a parent, whenever your child is being bullied, you know, you need to do something. That's just what it is, you know. I mean, but in particular neighborhoods like where I'm from, oh man, to do something is so much. It's the real deal, you know, it's a war zone. It really is, even in the schools, you know. And the thing is it's real to the point where people die. It's not even, you know, it's not even just, you know, somebody getting whooped on and all this, because, you know, when somebody get whooped on, you know, there's somebody that's upset about that. And there's people, you know, that come back. And they come back real. They don't just come back just like this. They come back like this. They're not playing games, you know what I mean? So, you know, this is real serious. So this is a real serious issue that they're tackling here, you know. And I don't think anybody got love for bullies too much. Like, if you've ever been bullied, I don't think you got love for bullies. So, you know, and you know, the moral of the story is these bullies don't deserve no love. After you, you know, dish out all that hate and everything that you do, and you put out all that bad karma, karma need to come back to you, pay you your just deserves. But let's get back to it. Let's let that tell the story a little bit more.
When I was down, fuck what you say, just don't hurt.
Yeah, that's right.
It don't hurt,
and I don't need you no more. Don't wanna see you no more.
Right.
Bitch, you get no love. You show me nothing but hate. You ran me into the ground, but what comes around comes around.
That's right. And that is, it's so beautiful that the little guy went head on, got his hair braided up, and he decided, you know what, I'm about to fight all three of these guys. And that's what he did. And then he put it on them with such intensity. Ow! And wasn't nobody mad at him when he did it. Was nobody mad at him. You know what I mean? And, you know, and back to real life, you know, in bullying, you know, especially where I grew up, it was like this. There are some people that just have bad intentions. Some people that are ready for war. And the thing is you are going to get tried. It's not a question of, well, it is a question of when. It's not a question of whether or not it's going to happen. It's a question of when, you know. And there are a lot of individuals that gang up and just, you know, and just let you have it. They just stomp you in the ground, just give it to you. You know what I mean? And like I said earlier, you know, you can handle it in a couple ways. You can learn to run, you can learn to fight, or you can learn a little bit of, you know, both of them. And personally, I learned a little bit of all of it. I learned, you know, and even because in that environment, you know, it kind of, it makes you a fighter, basically. You know, you don't have a choice because the fight is going to be brought to you regardless of, you know. And when it's brought to you, and you know, after so many years of it and all that, you just adjust to it, you adapt it to it, so you become a fighter. You just do. And so your dogs have had multiple altercations. You know, I've been in fights. I've been in a fight with like 13 guys, and that's just straight up. I'm not even kidding you. You know, and they wanted to rob me. But you know, and you know, I fought the guys, and you know, it is what it is. You know, but the thing is, you know, like, I wasn't even as scared at first, because at first it was like, shoot guys, two guys. It's like, man, I'm accustomed to this. I've been jumped multiple times, you know. I live in a city of bullies, and that's just what it is. You know, you will get bullied. You will get handled unless you handle yourself. You know what I mean? And, you know, but then they start, you know, now looking, there's guys coming from all directions. They done ganged up on, it's time to fight, you know. And of course, I tried to get away from it, you know, because that was a bad saying for me. But, you know, sometimes you can't get away. You got to deal with it, like the little guy did. And so I ended up dealing with it. And this is me in school, literally, me in school. And I had to deal with it. So it came to a point where I realized that I'm on my own in this and I gotta fight these 13 guys. So I took my gazelles off, in my inside pocket, and I went up to the line of guys that were in front of me to whoop on me. And then somebody stole me from the back, which was beautiful for me because I didn't want to see that coming. I just didn't want to see it coming. But I also knew that once somebody hit me, I'm in my zone. Let's get it, baby. So that was beautiful. So as soon as somebody got me from the back, I started getting the people in the front. La, 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 la. And we gave it to each other. But anyway, that's what you bullies get. Anyway, I hope y'all like the vibe. So go ahead, like, subscribe. Come on back so we can chop it up. Kick it. But yeah, your dog be back with some more ever. And still them bullies, it gets no love. No love. I'ma holler.